Hey guys, quick update for MonoRed Standard. Whole monitor. Everybody was telling me like, hey, you know, MonoRed has a new one drop. I was kind of hoping for, you know, like a Goblin Guide or something. But whole monitor has actually been quite okay. There are situations where you can make your opponents Elder Gargaroth, you know, Lustrous Beast or these kind of creatures, like not being able to block, which is pretty relevant. And it's definitely an upgrade to Fireblade Charger. Not that the card was any good, but if you are playing MonoRed, you do need to get on board really quickly. So other than that, nothing really changed. It might just be the most popular deck on ladder at the moment. And it's just fast. So if you're looking for something to play and, you know, clear your daily quests or just get a few games in, MonoRed's still a decent choice. There's a lot of Sultai, there's a lot of Rogues. Both of those matchups are decent for you. You don't really want to play against adventure decks, but at least on the ladder, you don't know that your opponent is playing MonoRed. Like if you're playing a tournament and your opponent is playing an adventure deck, whether it's Teemer or Naya or Gruul, whatever it is, they can basically just mulligan to five and keep three lands, Bonecrusher Giant and Lustrous Beast, and that's going to be a better that's going to be a better hand than your seven than your average seven cards. So I think it's a decent deck for ladder. Not sure about, you know, tournament play, but if you're just looking to get some quick games in, this should be fine. So let's play some games. All right, I kind of want to make this into like a, not like a speed run, but just try to see how quickly we can play, you know, three or four games. Just in case you are looking for a fast deck. There isn't really anything much faster than MonoRed in Standard. I guess Mono White is a deck, but something like Winota is okay too. All right, this looks a little bit better, and I guess we're throwing away a Torbran. Like, we already have one expensive card in Embercleave. Mono White, that's not a great matchup. Ooh, red white possibly, okay. I wanted to try to get their like Luminarch or something, which would be better than killing the 1/1. And if they don't have anything like that, then we can just pass. If they have Bonecrusher Giant, oof, we're in trouble. I'm gonna offer the trade here, even though normally like the more creatures you have, the better Embercleave gets. Oof. Okay, this is going to be a tough game. Unfortunately, my opponent has creatures in play that are doing something even when they don't play land, so not sure if this Rubber of the Rich is going to be able to do anything. Basically almost dead next turn. I need to draw a land into... Yeah, I don't think we have a lot of great options here. Wow, they didn't block? That is surprising. Oh, I guess I should have used my Rimrock Knight. Could try to block the 3/3, make him bigger. Ugh. All right. So this looks a lot like Winota. I think we want another Frostbite. I don't think I want Ekron War. Phoenix is a little slow. This doesn't kill Winota, so that's not really that relevant. This does kill Winota, but they have a lot of white creatures. I don't think I want that. Like maybe on the draw when you need to be a little bit more reactive. I think on the play I'll leave this. Leave it like this. All right, better seven. The card quality in the MonoRed deck, not the highest you have ever seen. If you want to play good cards, you need to play adventures or something, but not really this kind of deck. I might Frostbite this and then play Bone Crusher as a 4-3. No, I want the extra card, I think, or the extra value. Because if I just play the Bone Crusher here and my opponent just plays Skyclave Operation or something, then that'd be pretty awkward for me. Like, I kind of just want to kill that creature, untap, late or brand if I can. That's fine. So they have a Bone Crusher as well. Yeah, I think we're going to kill this guy. Oh wait, they don't have a Bone Crusher. Interesting. I could rip. No, I'm just gonna play my own Bone Crusher. I think that's best. And pass. The main phase Red Cup melee. Interesting. So this allows me to trade Thorbrand or trade Monitor for the Skyclave. And if my opponent has Winota, they just take three. Probably attack back, which is fine. The question is, do I actually attack? I think I do attack. They don't have any creatures. That's generally good for me, so. Okay, well, that's going to make me a 4-4 at least, so it's not the end of the world. I can even attack with the Haven, I guess. Haven attack, and then if they block, I Rimrock. Yeah, that seems okay. At least they have to sack a land if they... Maybe the monitor does not attack. If it does, like they block with the one with the charger, I bump it, we trade, I get a 1-1, they go to 5, and I still have a Frostbite. I guess that's okay. But that was still a fine deal for me. I guess if I only attack with the land, then I get to play the Rimrock Knight, but then I don't get to use the pump ability from it. It's tempting to attack here because obviously you're attacking for 4, but at the same time, you could just try to double block the Faithless Haven and survive that way. Like, no, I just killed this guy and they're just dead. All right, 1-1. I think I drew 3 Frostbites or something. Like, we just had all the removal in the world. Double Frostbite, Bone Crusher Giant, and a bunch of bad creatures. Gets the job done. Scorching Dragonfire on the draw might be okay, because they really have a lot of small creatures and just, like... I don't think cards like Fireblade Charger are going to be that great on the draw, so I just want to have some extra removal here, I think. Even Rimrock's kind of like, not that great. Yeah, let's try it like this. Now, the biggest creature they have is Winota, which I don't really have a lot of answers for, but I also don't really want to have Redcap Melee in my deck against just all white creatures. That seems like a good hand. Basically, you're hoping to get Bonecrush Giant. Bonecrush Giant is the best card in the in these like creature mirrors. Okay, that was a nice draw. I guess I'm not really sure if I'm supposed to play it here though, because if my opponent plays Luminarg here, I have to kill it next turn, and then I just use my mana really badly. All right, that worked, and they did it for some reason on their own turn, which means that I get to attack with Robber now. Was this strange play? They play the Bonecrusher, that's fine. I get to Frostbite it for three, or play my Annex, that also works. But if I think this is better. I think killing it is better because I'll get to just get a card for free from my Robber, and that's a pretty big deal. And instead of playing Fervent Champion, I think I'm gonna just play Rimrock Knight after combat. Because this way I can, get something with from Robber, which I think is good if I get, okay, nice. I'm not gonna be able to learn really, but a free creature is a free creature. I'll take that. I am kind of looking for a land here, so I could just loot away the Fervent Champion. I think that's the worst card in my hand. Yeah. All right, nice. We're doing it. Okay. Depending on what's in my opponent's hand, like it is even reasonable to just attack with the Faceless Haven here. Could have also used the Rimrock to attack for more, but I think I would just rather save it in my hand just in case my opponent's gonna kill my Annex. Oh, it gets exiled, okay. So I wanted to make its power 4. But they would need to have something like a Frostbite of their own or a Redcap Melee or something. It doesn't really work against this. Yeah, that's okay. Okay, now we're drawing a little bit too many lands now. I guess I kind of have to go for the cleave here. I don't really have a better option. I suppose I could just activate Haven attack with both. They take 6. That's the same thing as cleaving. The problem with cleaving now is they just take 6. Next turn I'll take 5 on the swing back, and then they can just like kill my guy or whatever, and I'm not dealing any damage anymore, which is not ideal. Yeah, I'm not sure. If I attack with this, I get to play Rimrock Knight, but I don't even really know if I want to play it, because I would kind of just rather use it to pump the Professor. Are we cleaving? Are we attacking with the Haven? Attack with Haven, I could attack for 8. I think I'm attacking with just the Professor. Ooh, okay, then that's perfect. That worked a lot better than I was hoping for. So they go to 8, and I still have a Rimrock Knight. Hopefully they don't Winota me here or something. Yeah, it's slightly annoying, but 2 turns from now, I can attack with a Double Strike Haven. Now it just depends on whether or not they have removal. Oh my god, I really did draw a land every single turn after I looted away the champion, huh? Yeah, we're gonna attack here.
Okay, that went well. All right, I'll play Arachnid. I just want to have a creature in play for next turn. Like, this guarantees me. Oof, I take five. Two triggers. No Kenrit, please. Okay, I got nothing. Okay, they have Winota. Do I win? Can Faceless put it on Faceless? It's 10, 13. I think so. Yeah, it doesn't really matter where I play this. Yeah, I guess they need to have... If I put it here, it's worse against Bone Crusher, but if they have Bone Crusher, they can just survive anyway. So they need to have Wreck Up Melee. Whew, what a game. I guess I got pretty lucky that they only got a 1-1 and a 3-1 out of the Winota activation. Like, normally, you know, you get like a double Strigoi and Kenrit and like these kind of creatures, so... That was a pretty close match. Pretty close. Not exactly the fastest MonoRed game either. I think it took 15 minutes. Just like, kill your guy attack. All right, let's go arena, come on. Not exactly cooperating today. All right, well, game number two. Before we start game number two, let me remind you that cfbboxbreaks.com, if you go there, you can check out how Channel Fireball does box breaks for either random groups of people where you get the cards assigned randomly, or you can just have a box break of your own if you want to open a box. They have a Twitch account, a Twitch channel where you can just watch everything get opened. Maybe you can sweat your friends, maybe you can, you know, just get a box for yourself. And yeah, it's a nice way to get some of the new cards if you're looking for Strixhaven, but I think they also have Pokemon and Flesh and Blood and even some sports cards. So give it a look and good luck if you're opening something. Better luck than I had, hopefully, because I didn't really get too much. Nomad thing. So this is Sultai, probably. Very likely Sultai. Or I guess could be some blue-black control. Yeah, this is getting killed, so no free trigger. Sultai is generally a decent matchup. Okay, this is Esper though, then that's a different deck. All right, let's go with Annex. So if they play some kind of sweeper, at least I'll get a creature or two out of the deal. With the double Faceless Haven, I don't really mind if they have a bunch of sorcery speed removal, because the Haven's going to be extremely annoying for them. Extinction out for one, yeah, that's rough. That is a... Yeah, I guess these days, like, everything in Standard just exiles anyway. In these situations, there's like no reason to sandbag your Bone Crushers to try to kill something. Like, you just need to deal damage, so just play it as a 4-3, no need to, you know, hope that you get to shock something. Extinction Event, that's fine. It's still also better than attacking with the Faceless Haven, I think. Now I can attack with Haven and play Rimrock Knight. I think that's reasonable because I still get to like do things in one turn. So 1, 2, 3, attack. They go to 13. Play this guy. And just make sure we keep the pressure up. Yoriana hand is okay. Okay, that's interesting. So, are they going to have another like Shadows Verdict or something? I'm going to play the Xanax. I don't want them to kill my Faceless Haven here. And if they are forced to kill Rimrock Knight, then that's okay, because I'm going to add another creature into play. So puts them into an awkward situation. Like, I'm basically not really risking running two creatures into a sweeper, because they are really incentivized to kill this. So mana spend doesn't matter, so they just kill a creature. Okay, sure. They play Orianna. I actually do have 5 damage to kill it, so that is nice. Okay. Land Orianna. Just mono removal. Scry. Okay, then they're playing. In that case, then I believe that they have Lanurion. Okay, so I'm gonna save both of these so I can kill it and attack. So hopefully I'm gonna draw a land, which would let me either attack with the Haven, do both, they take 6, or it would let me Frostbite, Bone Crusher, play the Bone Crusher, attack for 3. Obviously, it's not going to be neither now that we drew this guy, but at least we get to kill Yorion, which is nice. And then I can just play this Rimrock Knight in deck for 3. Yeah, that's deck for 3 here. If they have another sweeper, then I can just keep attacking with the Faceless Haven, so that wouldn't be the end of the world. I think the worst card my opponent can have is make two Angels. That'd be the worst for me at this point, I think. If they just keep playing sweepers, like, sure. I'll keep attacking with my Faceless Havens, I guess. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I can. I can just second annex, right? 3 and 4. Can they do anything? White mana? I don't really think there is anything for white mana. Yep, it worked out. The MonoRed deck is pretty resilient, like, thanks to the Faceless Havens and like cards like Annex, like making you extra tokens when they die. Like, you actually don't really mind playing against like all these kind of all removal decks. But let's see what we can do after sideboard. So Embercleave is generally bad against decks that have, you know, a million removal spells. But so is Frostbite, which is even worse. Vortex is okay. Phoenix comes back from the graveyard, which is nice. I'm actually going to bring in Ox, because if all they do is kill my creatures, then sure, let's play that game where eventually I'll just play Ox and draw some extra cards. And I think I might just keep 1 or 2 Cleaves, because it does make all my creatures into big ones. so that I can attack through, like, you know, Yorion, or if they have the 3/4 Angel guy or Pegasus guy or whatever that is. Yeah, I'll have Duke Leaves. I think I just need to have them against the 3/4s.
Need a way to re-spark the excitement in your TCG collection? Box breaks are the way to get your hands on cards from the games you love. Learn more today at cfbboxbreaks.com or check out CFB Box Breaks on YouTube.
All right, decent hand. Not spectacular or anything, but it will do. You're looking for the 4/3 land. Like, that's probably your best card against these kind of decks. Glass Cask on the 1/1, sure, not a big deal. A 2-drop here would be nice to just keep up the pressure. Well, the whole monitor is a haste guy. I'll take it, I guess. Everything that has haste is great against the sorcery speed removals. Yep, keep exiling the 1/1s. That's great for me, because then they might not have a good removal for the Phoenix here. It's actually a nice combo. Like, Thorbrand and the Vortex deals 3 a turn. This is not a great combo with Doom Foretold, by the way. Okay, I guess. Yeah, I'll sacrifice my Phoenix. Yeah, Champion Vortex seems pretty good here. Like, playing Thorbrand doesn't really make a lot of sense, I don't think. I might just get my guy swept by Extinction Event here, though. Another Doom Foretold, okay. So next turn they have to sack 2, so they have to sack the Glass Casket and the Doom Foretold. So what is going to happen here? Let's see. So I have to sack 2 now, so I'm going to play Thorbrand afterwards. So I guess I'm sacking Vortex and Monitor. No, Vortex and Champion, probably. And then they sack this and this. And then I have to sack 1, so I'll probably be sacking this. I guess I should keep Fervent Champion. That's probably going to be better. 1, 2... Good thing about sacking playing Thorbrand here is it doesn't, like, Shadow's Verdict or Extinction Event, neither of those two cards deal with my entire board. And I'm gonna keep the land in hand just in case I need to discard something to Doom Foretold. Oh, I really hope they don't have like White Omen in response. That'd be brutal. You were in hand. That can't be too good for them. Oh my gosh. I could have killed them, I think. Now I have enough because I sacked the champion. I have enough with the Phoenix from the graveyard. Yeah, I should have definitely done that. Because, like, even if this dies to something, I think I still want to bring this back rather than play the Annex. Well, now I'm kind of, like, priced into playing the Annex, so I don't really have another option. Yeah. I guess I have to do this now. And I should have actually played the land, because if I draw another one, I want to be able to bring back Phoenix, attack into Yorion, and then kill it after combat, so. Yeah, that exiles it. Vortex is okay. I don't really want to offer like two odd casting cost creatures into the event. I don't know if I have another option. Yeah, let's do it. 1, 2, 3. If you're doing this against like a green deck, you should usually exile creatures so that they can't scavenging ooze you. But against this kind of deck, it probably doesn't matter what you keep in your graveyard. But it is definitely something to keep in mind. They can Yorion, and I suppose they can recasket my guy here. But that would be bad for them, I think, because then this guy would be able to just... Ooh, Hull Monitor, hello! Is this lethal? One off? Wow, look at this guy. Just no big deal. Yeah, well, I guess we're doing it. Target creature can't block. No problem. Oh, it is lethal. I do have enough mana. Yeah, all right, all right. Hull Monitor. First time it actually did something relevant. Easy game, 2-0. No big deal. Didn't even draw the fourth 4/3 land. Did you guys see the Modern Horizon spoilers? Old bordered fetch lands. Take my money. It's already sold. All the boxes are sold out. Are you kidding me? Everybody sold out of Modern Horizons boxes, obviously. No, I was gonna order something. I wonder if the old bordered fetch lands come in normal packs. Two fetch lands. This set does look really good. I'm really, really excited to see the entire spoiler. So, any companion? No, right? Opponent took one mulligan. I have a 1-drop, 2-drop, 3-drop, basically. Yeah, it's okay. Multi 5. It could be something like Cycling. Maybe Sultai. Sultai would have Yorion, though. With Sultai, you do mulligan a lot of the time. Ooh, if they have the 2-mana guy that puts a counter on Savior, or itself, I guess, then I am kind of screwed. Not that I really have a choice. Block, 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 please trade, please trade. Didn't think so. All right, if they had Luminarch, they would have just slammed it a lot faster, so when there was the like little bit of a pause, that gave me hope. Yeah, I guess I'm just using Bonecrusher Giant. I might actually I'm just gonna block and make them discard. I think that's kind of the best I can do right now. Like, they're working with only 5 cards. Yep. So if I kill it, they can make it indestructible, but they make this guy 4/2. Then I kill it next turn. Sure. I mean, I'm still not looking very good here, but... I mean, hopefully I draw the line here. This is generally not a great matchup, like mono white with all these like indestructible thingies and, you know, save this, save that, make a big guy, put flying on it or whatever. Oh, yeah, I'm not gonna block, obviously. That is bad. So yeah, I'll kill this dude. I guess I can technically attack first, see if they trade. But that's obviously not gonna happen. Now I really need to draw a land. If they land attack with Faceless, I'm at 7. That's toss both. Yep. Okay, well I did draw a land, not a red one. I guess I should have specified that I wanted a red land. So I can play Annex. Now I don't actually get to do too much. I mean, I could attack and finish off the Magistrate and then don't play anything. Ugh. Oh boy, what's gonna be my turn? Robber pass, monitor attack. Yeah, I guess I just pass. Yeah, even though my opponent multi-5, they are going to be able to just beat me with the indestructible guy, unfortunately. Thing I kind of need to block. At the same time, I obviously want to have creatures for Embercleave, but I'm not in a position to start attacking, really. I guess I can just save my rubber for one more turn when I hopefully play Annex. Yeah, I can't really block here. I'm screwed either way, like one way or another. There really isn't much dead. Like basically every card they draw is at least like an indestructible protection for this guy. If they draw a land and this starts attacking. Yeah, I can only play Rimrock Knight. Yeah, sure. I mean, I guess I block, no. I can survive for like one or two more turns, but in the end, I'm just gonna die to the 4/2 indestructible anyway. This thing comes in. I wonder what I board out in this matchup. Phoenix, probably not great. Rimrock Knight's pretty bad. I think that's my worst card actually. Frostbite comes in. How about the Akron War? I don't know if it's that great in this matchup. Like they can just give their guy protection with Ulsaid. I don't think I want Akron War. I'll just leave him the one Phoenix. Cause I don't want to have too many expensive cards. That's the problem. I'm also not super excited about having so many 1/1s, but Fireblade Charge is actually kind of decent in this matchup, so it's not that bad. All 5 enemy colored fetch lands appear at rare and can be found in regular draft boosters. Okay, but where do I find the ones with the old border? That's the question. Each set booster contains a guaranteed foil and art card. Okay. Play first. Yep. Whoa, a 1/2? What the hell? You're not supposed to do that. I'm not gonna kill the 1/2, am I? Ugh. No, I'll just pass here. I need to keep this for Ulsaid. Like, if I just kill this just so I can deal one, my opponent plays, or not Ulsaid, the Luminarch, and my opponent plays Luminarch, and then, like, I look at my hand and think, like, okay, I guess there's nothing I can do, then that wouldn't be very good.
Now the question is, do I kill Savior or do I kill... Now I think I need to kill this because the 1-2 body is actually relevant. And I can attack through the 1-1 and next turn play Torbran, so that's not a big deal. Or Embercleave. All right, just how we like it. Do they have different pictures? What the hell? So that makes my cleave cost a lot, but at least I can Torbran. Oh no! Oh no! You hate to see it. You hate to see it. Like, we actually have to play Snowlands because of the Frostbites, but normally if people just run Snowlands just, you know, just to play different, just to be different, then they do get pretty punished by Raiden. But here it's just nothing I can really do. Fight Frostbite? At least Seg the Savior. If I wait, I'm not really gonna change much. Yes, they might not Seg the Savior. We'll just do this, I guess. Not the best. Certainly not the best. Spending your turn four to spend 2 mana to deal 1 damage, not really how you want to do things. I mean, normally you're supposed to like kill the Savior, but at this point I would be happier if they let the Raiden die. So a 4-4 here is actually a big deal because I can't play the Torbran and attack. I was going to attack with both, but now that my opponent has a 4-4, that's actually a big deal. And I'm still going to do it, but I can't attack. Good thing is Torbran deals 4 now, but if they have something like a Skyclave, then I get screwed again. Yeah, that's rough. No blocks. I guess I could kill this. Get a 4-4. Attack. I can attack and just trade for the Raiden. That's probably okay, actually. Yeah, I don't think I would be unhappy with that result. I just don't think they're gonna block. Yeah, that's probably best. Interesting game. Yeah, that's rough. So I go to 5. Oof. That Stone Quill is really, really good this game.
the fact that it's a 4/4 like was such a big deal. And this guy too. Well, that has a reach. So technically, am I just dead actually? Because of the trample on serpent? I don't really have great block. I can just everything block serpent. Ugh. And that prevents, yeah, I don't think I can win. I don't think there's anything I can do. I can first, no, I mean, there's just nothing I can do. I can shoot something with bone crusher right now. But then, like, these are not dealing any damage. Yeah, I'm not gonna win this game. Mono white, too good against mono red. This matchup truly is not very good. If you were, like, on the play, and maybe if my draws are a little bit better, then maybe. But everything my opponent did lined up super well against me. Like, I guess game one, I also didn't really get to cast many, many of my cards. Because I had double colorless land and just only one red source, and two of my cards got stranded thanks to the Megas trade. All right, match number four. I think we're approaching the 45th minute. Opponent goes first, all right. Can't attack through that either, I guess. Where are all the rogues players? Oh my god, they immediately get a treasure? What the hell? All right, I think we're going to end this at 2-2. Double hole monitor against a 5-5. Yep. Yeah. That is going to be a close one. So let's just kill this right now so they don't get another free treasure. And I guess I have to attack. Yep. All right, that's gonna be a quick one. No reason to stick around, really. That was a pretty decent draw by my opponent. Yep. Akron War seems great. Phoenix is gonna die to Bone Crusher and all the Red Cap melees and stuff. The question is, do I want my own Red Cup melee? I think on the draw, I'm going to bring it in. On the play, I think I'm only going to have Frostbite. Is that reasonable? I think so. I'm going to board out, like, double Charger. What are my worst cards? Rimrock Knight's pretty bad, too, actually. I could actually have Phoenix instead of Rimrock Knight. Maybe that's better on the play. And on the draw, I'm going to cut them for Red Cup melees. That's just a thing in general. Like, on the play, you get to be more aggressive. On the draw, you should be a little bit more defensive. Because that's just the nature of how it plays out. Sure. Okay, land's good. I like that. Ooh, Red Cup melee, all right.
And now the question is, do I just annex here and possibly let them Scorching Dragonfire my guy, attack, get a treasure? Or do I just play Bone Crusher? I'm gonna try to live dangerously here. Hope they don't have the exile removal spell. Maybe I am supposed to bring in Redcap Melee even on the play, because they do have a lot of ways to get Dragon into play on turn 4. Or even on turn 3, as we saw in game 1. So if they had a way to kill my guy, they would have already done it. So this might be safe for me to just play Thorbrand and attack. They might have a Bone Crusher Giant. Wouldn't be surprised if they had that. I can also play Hull Monitor and kill both of their creatures and just stack. But then this just runs straight into the... Let's play Thorbrand. This would just run straight into the Bone Crusher Giant that they could have. All right, I'll take this. Not the worst. I'll have two tokens, which are going to attack for 6 next turn. Oof. Oh, yeah, that is pretty good. I guess I have Thorbrand, so it's not the end of the world. Just play this smash with everything? I guess. Can play another monitor and smash with everything. Plog walk. And they are really incentivized to activate the chariot here, I think. Yeah, let's just do it like this. Okay, so before blockers, we're gonna have some effects here. Kill your guy, that should deal 4 thanks to Thorbrand, and they take 3, 6, 9, 12. Oh wait, should I have done that? Should I have done that with Frostbite? So I can Bone Crush it next turn? I guess it doesn't really matter, there's not a lot of stuff that deals with my board here. They can play another Chariot, I guess. Yeah, I should have still done it with Frostbite. They can just have another Chariot, like all of a sudden they have... Yeah, I guess they're still dead to do. Human. Alright, now we're in the draw. So this is probably going to be worse than... Redcap Melee. How am I supposed to beat this? Holy crap, a 4-4 that makes 2/2s? On the play, that was okay, because I had the Thorbrand draw and their draw was kind of weird. Like, this is not great if you don't get the free tokens from it. What am I supposed to do on the draw? You just board out 2 monitors for 2 Redcap Melees and just hope it works out. Pretty slow. Have 2/3s, 2/4s, don't even have the lands, but I think it's the kind of matchup where you just need to draw well. Like, what am I really mulliganing into? I have good cards. Like, these are the good cards I can draw. I think I'm actually gonna Frostbite this, because I really don't want them to start playing Chariots and stuff early. And like, if they just play Magda here, I'm gonna be pretty screwed too. Literally just a 1/3. Okay. I can live with that. Not even gonna play my charger. Hopefully I'll catch something with the Bone Crusher Giant. I'll take my 1 damage. No problem. Yeah, I'll keep the Bone Crusher. Oh, that's rough. No.
That is rather unfortunate. Yep. So what's my play here? I guess draw and hope. Land dragon, pack it in. I'm not gonna block. Yeah, I don't think we can win this game. I guess there is some universe where I block, guild this. Could play Annex here. Let's see. I mean, maybe they just have only lands, but if they had only lands, they would never play the Chatter Skull Smashing. So both of the cards in their hand, I think, are non-lands. This spells a lot like Embercleave. Block, block, cleave me, and that would be the end of it. All right. Yeah, we won the games where we played lands, and I think we lost the games where I got stuck on two, so didn't really, you know, learn too much, but what's happening? It doesn't really matter what happens here. I take six trample anyway. Yeah, I think Hole Monitor is better than Fireblade Charger, so it is an upgrade for this deck. It was pretty good in that one game where it stopped the Yorion from locking. But other than that, I mean, Hole Monitor is still not a card you want to play in Constructed Magic, unfortunately. So unless they print, you know, something like a Goblin Guide or some really good early game creatures for MonoRed, it's still going to be like just like on the verge of, you know, a fine deck, playable deck, but not really number one or anything. For that, this deck would need better creatures. So, you know, slight upgrade, but still doesn't really make me excited to play MonoRed. I'll just leave it at that. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.